This workshop will be very informal workshop. So we can talk in Saraiki, Punjabi, Urdu, or whatever language. Because our purpose is not to teach you theory. Because you already, mashallah, know theory very well. So, but it's an hands-on workshop and discussing the tricks and trades of laparoscopic hernia repair. Now, before that, I would like to just have a brief introduction. Taki,
dosto ko. Azim Khan, Associate Professor Surgeon, Gulati Medical College,
DC Khan. Acha, aapka sir prior laparoscopic ka kya hai? Kitna experience hai?
Filhal to hum simple koli kar rahe hain.
Lekin koli aap karte hain? वो आप सेफली विदाउट असिस्टेंस सुपर विदाउट सुपरविजन आप करते हैं सो यू आर एक्सपीरियंस लैप्रोस्कोपिक सर्जन सर
एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर गाजी खान मेडिकल कॉलेज
सर
विद सेम एक्सपीरियंस डूइंग द
कोलिसिस्टेक्टमीज एंड यू डू ऑल कोलिसिस्टेक्टमी सेफली ऑल सॉरी डिसेक्शन वगैरह ठीक सर
डॉक्टर वेयर आई एम वर्किंग एज अ कंसल्टेंट फॉर द डीएचपी आई एम डूइंग लैप कोली
लैप कोली यू आर डूइंग इट फॉर सिंस हाउ लॉन्ग
2 years
राइट
डॉक्टर खालिद इकबाल सीनियर रजिस्ट्रार सर्जरी डीजी खान मेडिकल कॉलेज आज से 10 साल पहले लैब खोली करते थे अब ना कोई हाथ लगाने देता ना
क्यों सर हाथ क्यों नहीं लगाने देते उनको सर आप चलें हाथ लगाने वाला मसला भी हल करेंगे तो प्लीज आप भी तारुफ करा दीजिए पूरी टीम Right. Now, this is our team, and basically, any venture in life is actually a teamwork. And for a teacher, the pleasure is that his disciples and students they become better than himself. Now, I can proudly say that all my younger brothers and my sons, they are now better surgeons than me. So this is my pride, right? And this is my success, that my colognes are more sophisticated, more better, have got more, and you will see it tomorrow. Well, and I'm very grateful to Imran Masood Saab, very grateful to Vakas and all their team. They were very honestly looking for some kind of activity where we can disseminate this skills of laparoscopic surgery, not for a cosmetic purpose, but actually imparting that thing. And they were after me. They were more enthusiastic than us. And they asked us to just make a plan. And alhamdulillah, this is the first venture which we are doing with this team. But I would like to tell you a little background of it. And I will try my best that you don't feel bored. In 1994, I had an opportunity to go to Australia to learn basically a liver surgery. But at that time, laparoscopic surgery was actually in a very hype. So I had an opportunity to just peep around other theaters. And I met a person, his name was David Hunt. And he was a very, very famous laparoscopic surgeon. My supervisor was D.L. Morris. He's a renowned liver surgeon. I had an opportunity because I was after our registrars there as well. So I had an opportunity to learn these laparoscopic skills. And after 6 months when I came in Multan, so I started the laparoscopic surgery. At that time, there was a lot of resistance. And most of the resistance was from the seniors. And a junior assistant professor, for him to start it, and it was very expensive. I'm sure now a registrar can afford to buy a laparoscopic equipment. And second hands were very cheap. But somehow it was very expensive at that time. And so a person who does not have a practice, for him it was very difficult. Sarkari sector ke andar to khareedna, koi convince hi nahi hota tha. So anyway, in a long story, I'll just not tell you, but it was a very enjoyable, tough journey. Jaise sahara ka safar hota hai na, lekin hum akhar aap chashme tak pahunch jate hain. It was a tough, lone journey. I was fortunate that in 1994, again, I was transferred over here. And here also, I had all those problems. But what I did was that I was able to develop a team. And this picture is around 12 years back, maybe more than that.
Around 16.
Now, this gentleman is Armaghan. Thank you. And that's me. And this is how we started. And Alhamdulillah, now these training workshops is a regular feature in our department. We do basic laparoscopic, and I will invite you for a basic skills workshop as well. These workshops are on dry lab, and then we do it on a wet situation, I mean live situation as well. And this is one of the workshop. This was actually a laparoscopic workshop. And these are the dry workshops which we conduct. This was our colorectal training session. And this is how in our ward our team actually does. In this picture, all three are my sons. One of them is my physiological son. And others are my real sons, right? So this is how, see, he was a house surgeon only at that time. So this is how, jaise aapne kaha na, koi haath nahi lagane deta. This is how in our unit, actually we were, and this is an emergency operation theater. This is not an elective operation theater. So it's an appendectomy, maybe a perforated duodenal ulcer. It's an appendectomy. So this is how actually we have developed a team. And unless and until we don't have a big heart, and we don't actually hand over whatever we know to our juniors and our colleagues, then this laparoscopic surgery is not going to develop. Full stop. And this is Dr. Asim. He was my earlier trainees, I mean second or third trainee. And this picture is from his operation theater in Saudi Arabia, and he is performing an operation on a 3D laparoscopic procedure. He is also our trainee and now serving in Saudi Arabia. And this is one of the workshops. This gentleman came from Karachi, and you may see some familiar faces around. And this is my proud team. This, we call it S1 family. And we love each other like this. Right? So whatever you're going to see tomorrow is actually because of our team. And I will also suggest to you that in your own circumstances also, solo flight will not take you anywhere. It has to be a teamwork. So in this workshop, the objectives are very clear. We just wanted experienced laparoscopic surgeon so that we can share with them the tricks of doing inguinal hernia. We will be focusing on inguinal hernia alone. And we will just describe, and we will let you do it under supervision, that how to do a laparoscopy. So that is the basically objective. You are the target audience. On the first day, that is today, actually there was a whole 1 day activity in which we had to actually do some lectures and then do it on a dry lab where some techniques are. But then we realized that all of you, if you are doing laparoscopic cholecystectomy, you don't need that. And secondly, we also realized that you are busy people. Maybe it's not possible for you to spare 2 days. So you may not remain focused if you are come here for 3 days. So this is why in this 1 hour session, we will just tell you a little roadmap and some of the basics which are very important to know before actually scrubbing up and going into the operation theater. And tomorrow, there will be one operation which will be performed by one of us. And all six of you will be in operation theater and you'll be watching it live. So we will not be telecasting it on a monitor. Rather, you will be in operation theater. So one, and that operation will be performed very slowly so that each and every step is discussed in detail for one hernia operation. And then we will divide you in groups. If you are six, then three of you will go in one operation theater. Another group will go in another operation theater. And we have got five, six operations. So each one of you will have an opportunity to do some. Obviously, we will never say ki aap ye karke foran ja ke aap shuru kar de. Thoda matlab hame uska karna chahiye. Lekin ye hai ki you will have actually a taste of it. And jo kal jaate waqt aap sabse ahem message leke jayenge na, wo ye hoga, yaar ye to kuch bhi nahi tha. It was very easy. It's really not difficult. And I could do it. And I will do it. So if agar aap is message ke saath chale jayenge, to we will think we have done our job. Okay. Next, please. Jahan bore hone lage to aap mujhe bata dijiyega. Ye main thoda sa aapko jaldi jaldi na kuch cheeze main aapko batana chahta hu. With this background, inshallah, it will be easy to understand. See, agar aapko yaad hoga, ek zamane mein ye abhi bhi bikti hain. Trust bikti hai na abhi bhi. And in Bail and Love, it is written that this is mentioned to condemn it. So it should not be used. So we started our hernia operation from here, from hernia management from here. And then we went to an open approach, and it was thought that probably Bassinis repair is one of the best repairs. And after Bassinis, then someone talked about Melanies repair. And then when this mesh came and Lichtenstein repair came, before that there was a Scholdeis repair, which was actually overlapping of the transversalis fascia, which was also called Toronto repair. and it was considered to be one of the gold standards. And when Liechtenstein repair came, actually it replaced everything. Now in laparoscopic hernia, we actually do a Liechtenstein repair, but this is from the inside. We have a gap, we put a mesh on the gap. But in laparoscopic hernia, we go inside and we put a mesh from the back. That's it. That's it. But in this open technique, there are chances of missing a hernial orifice. There is a chance of missing femoral hernia. Here, when you put a mesh, this mesh covers three hernias. In fact, if you say four hernias, direct hernia, indirect hernia, femoral hernia, and arcuate hernia, which is also called suprapubic hernia. And so, this is a neglected, you know, entity. But when you do it laparoscopic, when you put a laparoscope inside, you find patients ki pehle aapne socha hi nahi tha, but they have got a hernia over there. So all four are covered with one mesh, right? And as you go down, the chances of damage to vas and vessels are more. But as you remain up, the things are so clear that the facial covers around it are very minimum. So chances of damage to them are very little, especially for recurrent hernias, which are operated open way, laparoscopic operation. Agar aapne recurrent hernia kabhi operation kare to kitna mushkil hota hai. Jisne pehle kiya tha, agar usne koi mess machaya hua hai, to usko repair karna bahut mushkil hota hai. But laparoscopically, when you go in a plane which is a virgin plane, as if operation has not been done at all. Because in a recurrent hernia, laparoscopic approach is great. So, I don't think we need to repeat the anatomy in, you know, these great people. Basically, in an open op, this is the inguinal ligament and this is conjoint tendon and this is the place where the gap is and which we bridge with that. I think we can just skip it. These are the advantages of it, better cosmetics. There is a debate going on nowadays that are we doing it just for the sake of cosmetics? And some people, they say that for a very small bibunocele, small hernia, maybe doing an open operation gives the same result. Iska faisla aap khud kijiyega. Hamare bahut sare senior colleague, they are of this opinion that if you have a small bibunocele and you can do it with this much incision and you know you are not going to damage that and you can put a mesh on the top, it's almost the same. But we leave it up to you, right? Cosmetics, definitely it is better. You may argue ke agar azarband ke niche ek nishan hoga bhi to kya farak padta hai? One may argue it, but there is no doubt that it has got a better cosmetics. Better recovery, obviously we have seen, inshallah, dekhega, Allah khair karit rakhe. कल जो हम ऑपरेशन करेंगे, दैट पेशेंट हम अपने लॉजिस्टिक पर्पज से भी उसको रात को रख लें, बट इफ यू ऑपरेट एट 9 o'clock, दिस पेशेंट कैन एक्चुअली गो होम एट मगरिब टाइम वेरी इजीली, बिकॉज मेन पेन इज बिकॉज ऑफ द स्कार. एंड सेकेंडली, सिंस यू हैव पुट अ मैश इन अ एरिया वेर देर इज नो पेन सेंसेशंस, एंड सेकेंडली देर इज नो टेंशन, सो एक्चुअली देर इज नो पेन, प्रैक्टिकली देर इज नो पेन. एंड देन ऑफकोर्स गुड विजुअलाइज, एनाटमी इज सो ब्यूटिफुली, यू विल सी इट. It will be so beautifully visualized, and this can never be beautifully visualized in an open repair. Is tarah in gallbladder surgery mein bhi aapne dekha hoga, in gallbladder surgery the anatomy is much more, and there's almost no chance of missing a hernia, whereas in open there is a chance for missing a hernia, and it is very good for recurrent. And I told you the reason for that, because in recurrent hernia the plane in which you go is a completely virgin plane, uske upar koi haath nahi laga hota. जब आप फ्लैप रिमूव करते हैं, बस सैक रिमूव किया एंड यू आर देयर. और एक बड़ी अहम बात, आप कहने क्या जरूरत है हर्निया करने की, छोटा सा, लेकिन इफ यू वांट टू एम्बार्क ऑन लैप्रोस्कोपिक सर्जरी, मे बी नेक्स्ट फ्यू इयर्स यू विल बी डूइंग विपल ऑपरेशन, मे बी यू आर डूइंग कोलोरेक्टल सर्जरी, मे बी यू आर डूइंग हाइटस हर्निया रिपेयर, मे बी यू आर डूइंग वजाइको वजाइनल फिस्टुलास, मे बी यू डू रिट्रोपेरिटोनियल सर्जरीज फॉर दैट. सो दिस इज अ वेरी गुड लर्निंग कर्व एज वेल. When there was an argument कि जी appendix को laparoscope से करने क्या जरूरत है, पतली सी लड़की हो इतने चीरे से कर दे, but if you have to do right hemicolectomy, then this is a very good step in going in that learning curve. So this has got a learning importance as well. When you do, and this dissection, this operation is much more demanding and difficult than laparoscopic cholecystectomy and appendicectomy, and I'll tell you the reasons for that. So when you embark upon such a difficult operation, I'm not going to scare you about difficulty and something, but obviously ye choti jagah par aapne kaam karna hota hai. So when you are able to do this, it means you can now step on to a bigger procedures. And is it a gold standard or not? up till now, literature may not say. In cholecystectomy, gallbladder is a gold standard. I'll leave it up to you. Kuch problems hain, wo aapko hume pehle pata honne chahiye. Ek to ye hai, ki anatomy badi unfamiliar hai. Shuru mein samajh nahi aata bande ko. Aur baaz ukaat, we have seen disasters. I have seen a femoral vein being ruptured. And putting clips in a wrong place mean pain, very, very severe pain post-operatively. That can be damaged. Bladder can be damaged. Because this anatomy is unfamiliar. Humne us zaviye se usko dekha nahi hota. And iska learning curve thoda sa long hai. Cholecystectomy ka shayad short hai. Iska thoda sa learning curve. Isliye we will recommend that do at least 15 procedures under supervision. Minimum 15. So that you see all varieties of it. And then you embark upon it independently. Tisra hai, thodi si mehenga hai. Uska hal, humari team ne nikala hai, wo hum aapko kal demonstrate karke bataenge. That is suturing. You can suture it and you can go without tacker. But obviously, suturing in a straight surgery is much easier. In a hernia surgery, suturing is more demanding. Because in a very narrow stage, or jahan aapne suture lagana hai, wo aapki aankhon ke samne, it's not present underneath you, or just on top of it. It is present at an angle. So it is sometimes very difficult. Pubic tubercle ka stitch lena, sometimes it is very challenging and it is difficult. But you learn it. However, till you don't do it, to hum aapko tacker ke saath bhi karke denge, inko pata hai ki main zara lazy hoon, so I use tacker, but I use, you know, that also, to wo hum aapko sare demonstrate karke aapko bataye. अब तो सूचरिंग आनी चाहिए यू नो कोलिस्टेक्टमी के बाद आपने कोई भी प्रोसीजर करना है तो वो एक इंडिया के सर्जन थे हिज नेम वाज प्रवीण भाटिया तो ही सेड नो स्कोप विदाउट अ स्कोप नाउ अ सर्जन मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड ही हैज नो स्कोप विदाउट अ स्कोप एंड ही मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड देयर इज नो फ्यूचर विदाउट सूचर राइट सो लैप्रोस्कोपिक सूचरिंग इज मस्ट एंड लैप्रोस्कोपिक सूचरिंग रिक्वायर्स प्रैक्टिस ऑपरेशन टाइम शुरू शुरू में लंबा होगा तो हम कितनी देर में कर लेते हैं सम टाइम 15 मिनट्स 20 मिनट्स 35 मिनट्स मे बी नाउ लेस टाइम देन ओपन बट इनिशियली इट हैज़ अ लॉन्ग लर्निंग आप शुरू में तो इससे आपने परेशान नहीं होना इंशाल्लाह हम कल कोशिश करेंगे बहुत स्लो करें कोई फास्ट मूवमेंट ना करें एक एक करके लेकिन जब आप लर्न करेंगे तो आप देखिएगा स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड जो हर्निया है ना यू कैन डू 25 मिनट्स 30 मिनट्स इजली बट दैट इज नॉट अ स्टैंडर्ड दैट्स नॉट अ यार्डस्टिक इफ यू डू इट सेफली एंड यू डू इट वन आवर इट्स फाइन इफ यू डू इट वन एंड हाफ आवर एंड डू इट सेफली इट्स फाइन एंड इफ यू डू इट क्विकली बट नॉट अ गुड सर्जरी दैट इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल इसके अलावा एनेस्थीसिया शुरू में प्रॉब्लम बाज़ का द एनेस्थेटिस्ट हैज़ टू बी मोर ट्रेंड एंड शुड बी अवेयर ऑफ द निमोपेरिटोनियम रिलेटेड issues, anesthetic issues. Ye sari different techniques hain. Tap. Tap is intraperitoneal. It's basically intraperitoneal. Transabdominal, preperitoneal mesh, in which you go into the abdomen, raise a flap, come out, and then put a mesh, and then replace the mesh back. But in case of tap, actually you remain in extraperitoneal space. And initially, this was very popular. Some people, they still do it. We started with this one, but now shifted to that one. Because we thought that doing laparoscopic cholecystectomies and colorectal surgeries and appendicectomies, we are more familiar with the anatomy through intraperitoneal. Moreover, there is a considerable number of patients in which, while doing TEP, you make a hole in peritoneum. And once you make a hole in peritoneum, the air goes in and then it is a mess because the space just collapses and then you convert it into intraperitoneal, you know, tap. So if you have to convert it, why not to start it straight away? Then of course, E-tap is another extended tap. This is another one and IPOM, but we'll just skip that. छोड़िए इसको चक्कर में पड़े ना। ये मैं आपको थोड़ा सा एक वीडियो दिखाना चाहता हूँ और ये वीडियो आप आज दो तीन दफा देखेंगे उसकी रीजन है रोकिएगा सो दिस पेशेंट हैज गॉट अ हर्निया ऑन लेफ्ट साइड बट इन ऑर्डर टू शो द एनाटॉमी रोक दीजिएगा इन ऑर्डर टू शो द एनाटॉमी वी जस्ट शोड द लेफ्ट साइड जब आप बाकी मैं कैसे पोर्ट डालना है वो हमारे कोलीग आपको बताते हैं सी दिस इज द हर्नियल ऑरिफिस, द प्लेस फॉर हर्नियल ऑरिफिस. इस जगह पर ये इसको वापस ले जाइए ताकि ये वैसल ये नजर ना आए, ना मार्क किया हुआ नजर ना आए. रुकिए, हाँ रोक दीजिए, रोक दीजिए. ये देखें, ये आपको नजर आ रहा ब्लू सा, ये एपिगैस्ट्रिक वेसल्स है, ठीक है ना जी. और ये वो है अपना हाँ मीडियल पार्ट ऑफ द अम्बिलिकल लिगामेंट. ये अम्बिलिकल लिगामेंट यूं करके जा रहा है ना, ये मिडिल पार्ट ऑफ रहा है. इसका ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट लैंडमार्क है. हमने अपनी सर्जरी के दौरान बुनियादी तौर पर इसके लैटरल रहते हुए हमने कूपर्स लिगामेंट या जो प्यूबिक ट्यूबरकल वाला एरिया वहां जाना होता है. देखें ये ब्लैडर है ना, प्यूबिक ट्यूबरकल तकरीबन यहां पड़ी हुई है ना, तकरीबन यहां सिंफिसिस होगी ना, प्यूबिक सिंफिसिस, प्यूबिक ट्यूबरकल तकरीबन यहां पड़ी होगी. उस प्यूबिक ट्यूबरकल को हमने इस तरफ से होकर अप्रोच करना है. ये बड़ी अहम बात है, मैं जब डिसेक्शन बताऊंगा तो बताएंगे. Once you just cut this one accidentally, then you are in a mess. You can damage bladder and you can damage all this. अच्छा, अब आप ये देखिए, और ये vast deference है, वो यहां से आके इधर से गुजर के जा रही है. And gonadal vessels, they go like this. Now, in if you do an open inguinal hernia, if you could, no problem, आगे कर चलते जाओ. If you could do a local inguinal hernia, in an open inguinal hernia, basically what you see is external spermatic fascia, then cremasteric fascia, then internal spermatic fascia, then sac in case of indirect hernia. Here, there is no such thing because internal spermatic fascia will become when it passes through deep inguinal ring. So before that, you just, abhi agli taraf main aapko dikhaunga, yahan sirf ye dekhiye, ye ek is tarike se ek summit bani hui hai, jo lateral side hai, idhar se artery aa rahi hai, jo medial side hai, wahan se vessel aa rahi hai. Aur jahan ye dono aapas mein mil rahe hain, और वो अंदर दाखिल हो रहे हैं डीप इंगोलन रिंग से, उनके दरमियान जो वी बन रही है, दैट वी कंटेन्स द ग्रेटर वेसल्स विच इज कॉमन फेमोरियल मेडुला, ऐसे करके. बस ये आपने याद रखना है. और इसकी जो ऊपर की समट है होल की, इन सुपर एपिगैस्ट्रिक वेसल्स दे आर पासिंग लाइक दिस. मूव फॉरवर्ड, विल फर्दर एक्सप्लेन इट. आगे चले, रुकिए. ये देखिए, ये वही मीडियल अम्बिलिकल लिगामेंट जो मैंने कहा था. दिस इज मीडियल अम्बिलिकल लिगामेंट, दिस इज मीडियन अम्बिलिकल लिगामेंट, जिसके साथ यूरेकस आगे जाके मिलता है. आगे, ओहो, ओके, नो इश्यू, ओके, रुकिए. नाउ दिस इज द एरिया विच इज कॉल्ड ट्रायंगल ऑफ डूम, बिकॉज अगर आपने यहां कुछ कर दिया तो ऑल वेसल्स, मेजर वेसल्स यहां पड़ी हुई. इसके नीचे नहीं, इसके अंदर कुछ भी नहीं करना आपने. आगे चलिए, see these are major vessels which are passing through. Aayye sir, assalamu alaikum. Okay, move. Okay, stop. And this is the inguinal ligament, lower edge of the inguinal ligament. Aur iske niche ye jo ek triangle ban rahi hai, this is called triangle of pain. Now this is called triangle of pain because two nerves, lateral cutaneous nerve of thigh and genitofemoral nerve, these two nerves actually pass like and this gentleman. Acha, ye isliye aham hai ki below this area you don't do any suturing, you don't do any clipping, and you just handle it, because if these are clipped, patient is going to have very severe pain. So in fact, practically speaking, if this is the hernial orifice, iske jo kuch aapne karna hai, iske upar upar karna hai, iske niche aapne kuch nahi karna. और नीचे जब आपने इसको खोलना है तो ऑन द वन साइड वैस इज कमिंग, ऑन द अदर साइड वेसल्स आर कमिंग. हाँ जी, वो हमारे दोस्त जो बाद में आए हैं, थोड़ा आप तारुफ करा दीजिए ताकि. और
जी, मैं डॉक्टर किलार कुरैशी, सर्जन हूं कोटद्दूस से.
ऑलराइट, ओके. तो अभी हमने थोड़ा एक तारुफ कराया है और कुछ बातें इंगोल हर्निया के बारे में बताई हैं. हमने ये अर्ज किया है कि द पर्पज ऑफ दिस वर्कशॉप इज एक्चुअली नॉट टू गिव एनी थ्योरेटिकल नॉलेज, बट एक्चुअली टू हैव अ हैंड्स ऑन फील ऑफ द एक्चुअल प्रोसीजर. तो बाकी इंशाल्लाह आप इंशाल्लाह यहाँ से आगे कंटिन्यू करते हैं, एंड इन ऑपरेशन थिएटर इंशाल्लाह वी विल डिस्कस सारी चीज़ें. नो सी, सो दिस इज द एनाटॉमी. आई होप नाउ इट इज वेरी क्लियर. नो व्हाट वी गोना डू इज, वी गोना डू इज, अभी दूसरी तरफ मांगे, रुक जाइएगा, रुक जाइए. ये हर्निया उस दर हर्निया नहीं था, वो सिर्फ दिखाने के लिए हमने किया. ये आप देखिए, ये इनडायरेक्ट इंगोइनल हर्निया है और यहाँ फिर ये एपिगैस्ट्रिक वेसल है. ये सॉरी, मिल गए, अभी इसमें नजर नहीं आ रही. ये जा रही है, ये जा रही है, ये इंफ्राएपिगैस्टिक वेसल जा रही है. अच्छा, और ये हर्नियल ऑरिफिस है. व्हाट वी गोना डू इज, वी आर एक्चुअली गोइंग टू कट इट फ्रॉम हियर और इसको यहां तक ले जाएंगे और इसको यहां तक लेके जाएंगे. शुरू में हम यूं लेके जाया करते थे, बट नाउ वी हैव लर्न्ड इट टू मेक अ कर्व लाइक दिस, बिकॉज वी विल, आई जस्ट डेमोस्ट्रेट टुमारो दैट दिस कर्व हेल्प्स टू पुट मेक अ गुड पॉकेट इन विच मेश कैन बी स्टक. ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट दैट. सो दिस इज हाउ वी स्टार्ट. जस्ट आपने होल किया, रुकिएगा. नाउ देयर इज अ प्लेन. If you are too superficial, then you will make a damage. If you are very deep, muscles, you will actually damage the muscle. Basically, how do you know that, you know, right plane is that when you make a cut, suddenly air goes, you see, na, air just went inside and actually creates a little pocket. And that actually is the plane in which you have to work. Now see it again, please. See, nah, see the one gush of air. Ye film thodi si fast chal rahi hai. Dekhiyega zara. Yeah. And that means you are on the right plane. Okay, now see, you move, keep on moving. You can use scissor, you can use hook. Stop please. Now once we reach over here, forget about everything. Just work underneath the medial umbilical ligament and try to find out the pubic tubercle and Cooper ligament on top of it. And that has got totally different color and sheen than rest of the tissues. This is why it is called hernia lighthouse. So our term is find the lighthouse. When we just make a flap, forget about vas, forget about everything. Just try to find out medially the lighthouse. I will show you how it looks like. It will just white. It will glow like this. White house जब आपके पास आ गया तो अब आपने ना आधा काम कर लिया. और उस जगह पर सिर्फ एक एहतियात करनी है. There in 30% of patients, there is a vessel which is connecting obturator artery with that of internal iliac artery. And that actually goes just over the pubic one of the ramus of the pubic bone, and that may be damaged and that leads to torrential bleeding. So usko bas sirf dhyan karna hai, iske alawa aur kuch nahi. Okay? Ye dekhiye, ab ye, as we are dissecting, and we have to stay on that. Said, now we forget about the dissection on this side. Just 1-2 fibers maybe, not more. But work here. And this is our drill. Tomorrow, inshallah, we will like to demonstrate that. See? This is the sac, white. But you forget about. This is the lighthouse. See? Ye shiny aapko bhi aur nazar aayega. Ye dekhen. This white thing is actually lighthouse, which is ligamentum of Cooper. जब आप यहां थोड़ी सी आप डिसेक्शन और करेंगे तो ब्लैडर विल गो ऑन दिस साइड. दैट्स इट. नाउ व्हाट यू फाइंड इज, नाउ दिस इज द सैक. अच्छा रुकिएगा जरा. तो आपने इधर से खोल लिया. अब आप ऊपर से फ्लैप को यूं नीचे किया तो वो जो अंदर जा रहा था सैक वो आपके सामने आ गया. इन केस ऑफ अ डायरेक्ट हर्निया, यू जस्ट डू लिटल टू स्वीप्स एंड इट विल जस्ट कम डाउन विदाउट एनी प्रॉब्लम. द ओनली थिंग विल बी अ सूडो सैक. यू विल फाइंड अ लेयर विच हैज टू बी पुश्ड बैक इनटू द स्क्रोटम एंड देन इट विल बी ऑल क्लियर. But in case of indirect hernia, what you see first is the sac. And there is no coverings. There is no internal spermatic fascia over there. There is no cremus hysteric fascia. So you just hold the sac just the way you do it open. And towards inner side, medial side, you keep on peeling it. Now when you peel it actually, the things are actually posterior to that. The moment you peel it, the area which you have peeled, just pick it up and peel it. The area which you made bare, just hold it, pick it up. So in this way, when you keep on doing it, your vas will go on this side, your artery will go on this side, and you will end up with just the sac, just as you do in open surgery. Now, please remember that the flap, when it touches that hole, that is the point, it is glued to it very strongly. So at that area, there is a chance that you make a buttonholes. Huh? G-point. Oh, it's just their love for, they call it J point actually.
It's documented now.
So I mean, we found in our, you know, studies that is the point where it is very stuff, and you have to be extra careful to move it from there. ठीक? अच्छा जब आप उसको यहाँ पहुँच जाते हैं ना, दूसरा आप याद रखिए, जितना आप distal होंगे उतनी dissection आसान होगी. So you try to go as distal towards scrotum as possible. So once you hold it, you keep on pulling. If you already know it's a bibonocoel, it's a small sac, just by gentle pulling and just by peeling the tissues off, it will come in your hand. And if you think it is not possible, and we will demonstrate it here, when you have got sufficient length there, you can blindly cut it with diathermy. And there will be no problem. And then the flap will come down. Now you keep on moving that flap down, 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 till you see the area where there is triangle of doom, there is triangle, everything is, the hernial orifices, which means femoral and inguinal are visible, and then you put a mesh. Let's see it, how we do it. There's nothing, just hold the sac and gently keep on peeling. You do it in open surgery, you are familiar with that. You keep on peeling. You keep on peeling. This video is going a little fast than the actual time. Here we go. When you go to the other side, you can safely cut it. You can safely cut it. Now this is the sac. And then this is the point where it is little more strongly touched. Okay. Ye dekhiye. Rokiyega?
Ji sir.
Ab ye sara pare kar diya aapne. Ye pura ka pura spermatic cord ke contents jo hai hernial se ja rahe hain. Ye infra epigastric vessels ja rahi hain. Ye epigastric vessels ja rahi hain. Inko bachana bada zaruri hai. Ye pubic symphysis thi, ek Cooper's ligament tha aur ye sari. Next please. Okay, this is the femoral, this is inguinal, and if it has been direct, it will be here.
Chronomartis.
Oh, chronomartis, yes. The name of that vessel is chronomartis. All right. Now this is femoral. So when you put a mesh, it actually covers all femoral. Ye mesh hai. Ye hum aapko kal demonstrate karke dikhayenge. Rukiyega. Now once we go there, there are 2-3 techniques. The technique which we will try to demonstrate to you, simple one is, we'll tell you how to cut the mesh, and then the outer upper, we will put a suture mark. Because it takes some time, half an hour or more hour to really orient that mesh. So we will put that, and this is the technique which we follow. So we'll push it in. When you go inside, you just forget about ki ye daayen taraf hai, baayen taraf hai, kaun sa. Just try to find out the suture and place that suture at the upper outer portion. And when you will do that, the inner corner of it will automatically be rest on the lighthouse. And lighthouse is the first place to be either fixed. So in this, we will demonstrate fixing it with the suture technique. But we will also show you how to do it with tacker. Tacker is easy. Suturing demands something. See, sir. So basically, you just suture it. It's just like open. And if you know this technique, you are really a very comfortable laparoscopic surgeon. No, you cut it. No. Okay, there are a lot of tricks which actually we will discuss on operation room. Here we go. In this, we are actually suturing it, but we can just use a tacker as well. Simple vicryl is placed, and this is sutures. And this is how the procedure is complete. Next, please. Any question up till now? I mean, the result tomorrow of this workshop will be that inshallah all of you will be saying, yaar, itna mushkil nahi tha jaise.
It all depends on the anatomical field. If you are clear about the anatomical field, then nothing will be difficult.
Exactly. You're right. Okay. Any other query before we move forward? Alright. So what is the future? We never know what future is. Next please. Now we will have about some of the
anatomy and troubleshooting.
Troubleshooting thi?
Troubleshooting is the last one.
Okay. Now, I'll request a colleague. Aap pehle pata hai ki
nahin?
Dr. Umair will briefly tell you about
the same anatomy will be.
But anatomy ke kuch points jo hai na jinko highlight karna zaruri hai. Umair?